Good morning, everyone. So last class we had studied introduction of GST, and we have seen what was the earlier indirect tax and what is the presently indirect tax structure. There's a huge transformation which has taken place in recent times. The government also has faced various difficulties in implementing the same, and time to time the government has catered these difficulties. Okay, so now we know on a single transaction GST is levied by the state as well as central. Previously it was like on manufacture it was excise, on sale it was service sales tax, on services it was service tax. And we also seen that in earlier indirect tax regime, few taxes was empowered by central government and few taxes were imposed by state government. But right now it's one single taxation, that is GST, and the single transaction both state and the central levies, right? Now basically previously it was manufacture, sale, service providing, but right now it is simply supply. As you can see in the screen, it is supply. So supply of goods or services or both. So today this is the taxable event. This is taxable event on what GST is levied. GST is levied on supply of goods, services or both. So we are going to analyze today this taxable event, because there will be a lot of supply on which GST will be levied, and there will be, as we have already seen, that there are few essential goods or services on that GST is not levied. So further, what are the conditions to be satisfied in order to be called as a taxable event? Like we have seen in direct tax, there are five heads of income, and we have seen that some, if conditions of that particular head, which is known as chargeability section, is satisfied, then we put that income under that head. So if a transaction is to be called as supply, it has to fulfill certain conditions. Accordingly, we can tell that particular transaction falls under the purview of GST. So we will understand these things in a much elaborated way, right? So now I've already told you here the taxable event is supply, that is supply of goods, services or both. Now this supply includes everything, whether it is manufacture, sale, rendering of service, purchase, entry into a territory of state, etc., right? So that is one single event known as supply. So if you manufacture, it is supply of goods. If you sell, it is supply of goods. If you provide service, it is supply of service, right? It has to be one single event, that is supply. Then previously it was respectively on sales we had sales tax, on manufacture we have excise, on services we had service tax. But under this present GST regime, it is simply supply of goods, services or both, and it includes everything, right? Because on a single, if it is a manufacturer, on that central will also impose GST and the state will also impose GST. If it is sale of goods, then central will also impose and state. So it's a single transaction on which both government imposes GST. So it has to be one single event, that is supply, right? We cannot just bifurcate, oh no, this is manufacture, this is sale, this is simply, you just check whether it is falls under the supply definition or not, right? So here the tax is being levied in an integrated manner, right? I have already told you, you do not have to read this entire PDF again and again. Simply just mark these words, so automatically you are going to get. And under the earlier tax regime, I have already told you that we have seen rather that on a single transaction, excise duty was also levied and the sales tax was also levied. So it was like independent way we charge different types of service tax. So that makes the product highly priced in the market. So our prices are not competitive in the global market as well. So we have introduced an integrated form of indirect tax, that is GST. So simply GST is levied on. If someone asks me, I'll simply tell GST is levied on supply of goods or services or both. Right? Now here they have given us the definitions of goods, services and all, right? This something, it's very easy and easily understandable, so you can just read it, right? Good means every kind of movable property other than money and securities. Securities means shares, right? Shares, debentures, right? And it includes actionable claim, growing crops. These are included in goods, right? Things attached to or forming part of land. Okay. Now, there are some more terms which you must be aware of before starting this chapter. So they have explained you the meaning of family as well, wife, children, and parents, grandparents, brothers and sisters, if they are only or mainly dependent on the said person, right? Wife, children, dependent, independent, it doesn't matter. Parent, grandparents, brothers and sisters, if they are only or mainly dependent on the. Now, this family definition is quite different from the direct tax laws, because when you see the direct tax, there in direct tax, you must have seen that the family definition mein grandparents do not come, right? It was like hum panch, wife, spouse, children, parents, brothers, sisters. It was hum panch, but here it is hum chhe, right? We have grandparents as well. So when you go for direct taxes, you need to remember that grandparents are not there. But out here in indirect tax, they are in the family definition, they have used grandparents as well. So this is a difference from direct tax, right? Now, so we are studying today supply, right? And there are some terms which we must aware before doing that. So goods is any kind of movable property other than money, stock, shares, but it includes actionable claim, growing crops or anything attached or forming part of the land, right? Family meaning I have explained you. The government means out here the central government, because we are studying, I'll explain, wait, right? Because we are studying CGST 2017, right? So this is CGST Act 2017. Okay. Now the local authority is the corporation, you know, Kolkata Municipal Corporation, panchayats, cantonment boards. So all these things you did not be reading so in depth, right? You can just go through. Now this definition is very important, the word business, right? Any trade, commerce, manufacture, profession, adventure, wagering agreement also, like gambling and all, or any other similar activity, whether or not it is for a pecuniary benefit or any items incidental to that. Sometimes I may not be engaged directly in trade, so I might be introducing the buyer and the seller and taking commission, right? So this is incidental. So on commission also the GST is levyable, right? Now any activity or transaction in the nature of one above, whether or not there is volume, even if there is no volume, frequency, continuity, regularity, it has got nothing to do with all those things, right? Supply of goods like capital assets in connection with commencement or closure of a business, right? Over there also, that all these things comes under the purview of business. Clubs, associations, society, right, which is for the benefit of the members, that also comes under business. So business includes simple any trade, commerce, manufacture, profession, wagering agreement, right, and any incidental items related to that, whether there is a volume, there is no volume, any supply of goods, including capital assets. Even if I'm setting up a business and I'm purchasing machinery, so on that also might have to pay GST, right? So all those things comes under business. Okay, now consideration. This is very important because see, all these things I'm just forming a base for supply, because I'll be explaining that taxable event, because I've already told you some supplies might be taxable, some supplies may not be taxable. So maybe there might be a case that I'm making a supply to a family member, that is why they have introduced the word family with us, right? So we have to see. So consideration has to be there. Without consideration, it's a kind of free services. On that, I should not be charged GST, but let's see what the scenario is all about. So the consideration is any payment made or to be made, whether in money or otherwise, means kind is also okay, right? In respect of supply of goods services, whether by the recipient or by any other person, means consideration by a third party will also be considered out here, right? I provided services to you, but your parents are paying me. That's okay. It GST has got nothing to do with it. GST mainly sees whether consideration is there or not, but shall not include any subsidy. So when we talk about consideration, so what are the points we need to remember? It's cash or kind, it doesn't matter, right? Third party also okay. Third party say you can get it, no problem. Right, do not include subsidy. Now, usually if I am getting any kind of deposits, that will not amount as consideration unless I'm adjusting that deposit, right? Suppose I've got an advance for sale of goods. So what entry do I pass in my books of accounts? It's like this, bank account debit to advance, right? So right now we cannot charge GST on it, but when I'm applying advance debit to sales, it means I have adjusted this proceeds against this sale of goods. So now I can treat it as, now it will be under the purview of GST. So initially when you get an advance, right, it may not fall under the taxable event, right, when you get advance or deposit, something sort of that. But when you adjust that advance against the supply of goods, so in that case, automatically the GST picture will come, right? Okay. Now we have actionable claim, right? A claim to any debt other than a debt secured by mortgage or movable property or by hypothecation, right? On this also GST is levyable. Okay, the manufacturer, the word manufacturer, earlier it was very complicated, right? When we used to study excise duty, we were confused as to which process amounts to manufacture and which process do not amounts to manufacture, right? So there was a lot of problems that we faced, right? But out here, the problems have been minimized. So it was like a manufacture simply means processing of raw material, converting that into finished product, having a distinct name, character, use, and blah, 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 right? So the word manufacture is quite simple out here, but earlier it was under the excise duty, excise law. It was quite complicated, right? So we are just getting accustomed with our various definitions, right? Services, it means supply of anything other than goods, right? Means anything other than goods, money, securities. Right, and but includes activities relating to use of money or its conversion by cash or any other mode, right? Suppose if I'm getting my dollars converted into rupees, so that's a kind of service, right? So on that service, there is a commission which the dealer takes. So on that, I will be charging GST, right? So activities relating to use of money or its conversion by cash or by any other mode from one form, currency or denomination to another form, for which a separate consideration is charged. There has to be a separate consideration, suppose if I am telling you that $1 I will give you 72. So simply the money has got converted. But if I am telling you that $1 ka I will give you 72 less 50 paisa is my commission. So here a separate consideration is charged for this conversion. So automatically on this 0.5 the GST will be charged, right? Now supplier can involve consignee as well. It is not necessary that I have to be the supplier. If an agent is acting on my behalf, then he is also a supplier, right? Now person, this is quite similar to what we have done in direct tax. It's an individual, HUF, a partnership firm, an LLP, an association of person or a body of individual, any corporation established under the central, state or government company, any body corporate like foreign companies, any cooperative society, local authority, state government, central government, right? Societies registered under the Societies Registration Act, trust, artificial judicial person not falling above like Calcutta University. Clear? So this definition is quite similar to direct tax, so I'm not dealing in detail. See, in these definitions we have nothing much to explain. You need to simply read it, right? And at least be sure that at least you are going to get two or three definitions of 2 marks each, right? So they might ask you to explain services, what do you mean by goods as per CGST Act 2017, or what do you mean by this, what do you mean by that. So they might tell you and ask you these questions, right? Okay, now the recipient, what does the word the recipient mean? The recipient, who is the recipient? I've already discussed with the supplier part. We need to see who is the recipient of supply of goods or services. Basically, the recipient will be the person who is liable to pay that consideration. Where a consideration is payable, the person who is liable to pay that consideration. And when there is no consideration, in that case, the recipient will be the person to whom the goods or the service have been delivered, right? Or is made available. It can include agents as well. Now we are not going to study the specific state GST laws, right? We will simply study the CGST and the IGST, and then we are going to study the supply definition as per CGST Act, right? It's quite similar because everyone wants to don't want to make it complicated, so they try to make it as at par with the central government, right? So the concept of supply. Section 7 of CGST Act. Now, this is the main part of the entire curriculum. We have understood as of now ki humko kiska credit milega, kiska nahi milega, kaise milega, kis pe IGST lagana hai, kis pe CGST, SGST lagana hai, kis pe CGST, UTGST lagana hai. अगर हम IGST payable है और उससे हम CGST, SGST का credit ले रहे हैं तो हमको central. और फिर अगर कोई यूज कर ले रहा है तो उसको पास ऑन मिलेगा. देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड बट द मेन पार्ट इज ऑन व्हिच ट्रांजैक्शंस वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई दिस जीएसटी, राइट? सो दिस पार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? एंड दिस इज बेसिकली चैप्टर 3 ऑफ द जीएसटी एक्ट रेड विद वेरियस शेड्यूल्स. राइट, सो these are the sections we'll be talking about. Section 8 is like meaning and scope of supply. Section 8 is like taxability of composite or mixed supply. There can be so many supplies which have been provided in a mixed manner or a composite manner, right? Now schedule 1, 2, 3, this is very important because we'll be discussing just immediately after this discussion. Activities to be retailer supply even if made without consideration means free services. Free. If I'm using the word free service, that doesn't mean goods are not there. Try to get free supply, right? So if a supply is done without consideration, still GST can be charged on it. So they are telling that activities to be treated as supply even if without consideration. Right? Now, bolo.
The Delhi government gives free water and electricity. So does that mean that the people of Delhi, they don't have to pay the bills, but they have to give GST to others?
हाँ ऐसा हो सकता है. It happens. अब जैसे मान लो तुम डायरेक्ट टैक्स में भी ये चीज है. हम जब लॉटरी जीतता है, when I have winning from lotteries, when I get the proceeds, right? So on that I will be asked to pay the tax amount. So out here they are very clear. Even if it is without consent, okay, fine. You have provided it free of cost, it doesn't matter. You don't take anything from the customer, but take GST. Right? So activities to be treated as supply even if made without consideration. This is number one. Schedule 2 basically focus on whether it is supply of goods or whether it is supply of service. As I have already told you in earlier indirect tax regime, software, it fall under the purview of both VAT as well as services. So here they have made it very clear that activities, these are to be treated as supply of goods or it will be treated as supply of service. So this distinction they have made. Okay. Now schedule 3, activities or transaction which shall be treated neither as supply of goods nor as supply of services. Right? And I've already told you that the state GST laws or the union territories GST laws are similarly based on central because they want to keep it at par. Otherwise, again, the problem will arise. Right? Please kindly go through. राइट तो शेड्यूल 1 क्या बोलता है एक्टिविटीज टू बी ट्रीटेड एज सप्लाई इवन इफ विदाउट कंसिडरेशन शेड्यूल 2 स्पेसिफिकली बोल देता है ये सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स है ये सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विसेज है एंड शेड्यूल 3 बेसिकली टॉक्स अबाउट द थिंग्स व्हिच डू नॉट फॉल अंडर द परव्यू ऑफ सप्लाई इट इज नाइदर टू बी ट्रीटेड एज सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स नॉट टू बी ट्रीटेड एज सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विसेज राइट नाउ दिस इज द लॉ डेफिनेशन व्हिच दे हैव गिवन अस राइट वी विल study and then we will analyze that right so now what we can do instead of just reading this you can just make a note in your copy right you can just make a note okay just write definition of supply because it will help us in remembering properly right meaning of supply section 7 right? Now, this is not point number one, this is subsection one. सबसे पहले बोलता है all forms of supply, right? So this is section
one.
This is subsection. This is clause, right? So they have made it very clear, all forms of supply, whether it is sale, manufacture, whatever, right? Now, even if barter system will also fall under supply, because it is like I give you something and you give me something in return. There is no consideration in cash, but it is in kind. Because I've already told you, consideration means cash or kind, it doesn't matter. So all forms of supply. Now I'm not going to write supply of goods or services or both, right? When I'll be specifically talking about supply of goods, I'll mention that. So out here, all forms of supply, right? Whether it is sale, you can write example. It is sale, transfer by different names, right? You must have heard, you must have done in direct tax capital gain, right? Over there, the definition of transfer was, it was sale, extinguishment of any rights, compulsory acquisition, destruction of any property, right? All was coming under the purview of transfer definition. So out here, everything will come under the definition of supply, whether it you call it as sale or you call it by the name transfer or whether you call it exchange, right? There are different forms of supply. So all forms of supply will come, right? Whether it is barter system, right, all forms of supply, made, etc., made for a consideration in the course of business. All forms of supply made in the course of business. Right? Now, under the supply definition, we will also have importation of service. Whether or not related to business. Now this is something very interesting. If it for goods, right, it has to be in the course of business. But if I am importing any service, it is not necessary that it has to be in the course of business. Right? Plus, clause 3 says schedule 1. Supply without consideration. That will also be considered. Supply without consideration. So section 7 deals with the meaning of supply. It says all forms of supply, right? I'm making you remember in the class so that you do not have to put very much stress at home. Sara hard work yahi kar lena hum logo ko, right? So all forms of supply, whether it is sale, transfer, exchange, barter, whatever, are made for a consideration in the course of business. Importation of service, whether it is made in the form of business or not, it doesn't matter. Schedule 1, even if it is without consideration, but few supplies will be treated as, will fall under the taxable purview. Right? Now, then we have 1A, section 1A. It deals with
section 1A.
Yes. Yes. No, no, subsection 1A, sorry. It is subsection 1A. It deals with schedule 2. This is also supply, because it specifically tells that this particular activity will be supply of goods and this particular activity will be supply of services. Right? So section 1 has three clause. 1A, that this is certain activities always constitute supply. Now it is also specified, either it will be supply of goods or it will be supply of services. Subsection 2, right? Notwithstanding, anything contained in subsection 1 right. Notwithstanding anything contained in subsection 1, these will not be treated as supply. That is, hum log pad chuke hain already, schedule 3 plus activities undertaken by C government, S government, local authority, in which they are acting as public authorities on the recommendation of central government. Or state government respectively. Right? Basically, state government, agar koi bhi activity kar raha hai, so it is, they're acting as public interest, right? So usme koi kamane ka koi motive hai hi nahi. Right? So that one will be specifically excluded. So basically subsection 2 deals with exclusions and 1 and 1A deals with inclusions. Right? And subsection 3 government recommendations of the Council may specify right bol sakta hai a supply of goods.
Council?
GST Council. Not to be treated as supply of services or a supply of services not to be treated as supply of goods. ठीक है, सो ये हम लोगों को याद रखना है, बहुत सिंपल है. सप्लाई का डेफिनेशन क्लियर है, क्योंकि एग्जाम्स में क्या होगा, आपको ऐसे 7-8 केस दे देगा, ट्रांजैक्शंस दे देगा, और आपको बोलेगा कि ये सप्लाई है कि नहीं बताओ, वेदर इट इज टैक्सेबल इवेंट और नॉट. तो आपको चेक करना होगा. वन सेक्शन वन कंप्लीटली डील्स विद ये सप्लाई है. वन ए भी डील करता है कि सप्लाई है. टू बोलता है कि ये सब सप्लाई नहीं है. और थ्री बोलता है गवर्नमेंट मे नोटिफाई कि ये सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स है, सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस नहीं है. ये सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस है, सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स नहीं. इज दैट फाइन? राइट. सो वन बोलता है, वन ए भी बोलता है, राइट, दैट इज शेड्यूल टू. टू बोलता है नहीं है, शेड्यूल थ्री एंड एक्टिविटीज अंडरटेकन बाय गवर्नमेंट एज एक्टिंग एज पब्लिक अथॉरिटीज. एंड थ्री बोलता है गवर्नमेंट ऑन रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ द काउंसिल मे स्पेसिफाई अ ट्रांजैक्शन टू बी कॉल्ड एज सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स नॉट टू बी ट्रीटेड एज सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस, और इट कैन बी सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस नॉट टू बी ट्रीटेड एज सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स. राइट, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू एनालाइज दिस. दिस एनालिसिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Now we have studied this entire definition. You can read at home, right? ये बहुत important definition है, आपको पढ़ना ही चाहिए. Very 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 important. कई बार आपको directly definition भी पूछ सकता है, और they can give you 7 to 8 cases, and you have to simply identify which is a taxable event, which is not, right? Now out here by seeing the definition we can easily make out that it is an exhaust, it doesn't give an exhaustive look, right? Exhaustively ko nahi bata ki ha ye supply hai ye nahi hai, bas khali ek definition create kiya gaya jisse ki koi bhi cheez chhoote nahi, right? So this definition is an exhaustive definition or an inclusive definition. Hum log bolenge this is inclusive definition, and it doesn't give a much clear cut instruction ki ye exhaustive definition nahi hai. The list is not exhaustive, yaad rakhiyega. Because many places they have used the words such as, see out here, such as. गवर्नमेंट अपना कोई तो रास्ता छोड़ेगा. अगर एग्जॉस्टिव डेफिनेशन दे दिया तो बाद में वो लोग क्या करेगा, उसको कोई भी ट्रांजैक्शन को दे विल नॉट बी एबल टू पुट अंडर द परव्यू ऑफ जीएसटी इफ दे वांट टू, राइट? So simply they have shown money and securities. ये तो goods ही नहीं है. तो ये अगर goods नहीं है तो GST का बात ही मत करो, इसलिए ये circle के बाहर में है. Supply of goods, supply of service या दोनों, ये supply माना जाएगा, and कुछ कुछ तो supply माना ही नहीं जाएगा. Now ठीक है, तो you can write short फटाफट supply of goods and services except money and securities, because these do not attract GST. Parameters, right? Money, securities do not attract GST, because we know goods ka definition mein ye sab ka aisa hi aayega case study. Okay, supply should be for a consideration, I know, but I will write here must read schedule one, because there are few supply which is made without consideration, वो भी taxable event होता है, right? Supply should be in the course of business. I okay with it, no problem. मेरा business से related होना चाहिए, but importation of service may or may not be related with business. Importation of service except, remember this. तो देखो हम लोग definition पढ़ लिया ना, हम लोग को easy हो रहा है बात करने में, right? लिखा supply should be for a consideration. I know, but must read schedule one because there are few supply which is even without consideration they are treated as supply. Business से related होना चाहिए, ठीक है, लेकिन importation of service जरूरी नहीं है, business से रिलेशन रखे, ठीक है. तो कॉमन सेंस क्या है, बिजनेस से रिलेटेड होना चाहिए पॉइंट, अगर देखे तो गुड सर्विसेज होना चाहिए और कंसिडरेशन होना चाहिए बस. और यहां पे लिखा है देर आर फ्यू एक्सेप्शंस ऑफ पैरामीटर सेकेंड एंड थर्ड. क्या बोला मैंने, कुछ कुछ ट्रांजैक्शन विदाउट कंसिडरेशन शेड्यूल वन और इंपोर्टेशन ऑफ सर्विस, देख रहे हैं मेरा बात. तो अब आप लोग को ये वाला पेज पढ़ने का दरकार नहीं है, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू आउट हियर. तो ये फॉलोइंग पैरामीटर्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ये तीन सप्लाई होना चाहिए गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज का, राइट. हम लोग सब शॉर्ट में समरी बना रहे हैं, जितना हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे उतना हम लोगों के लिए अच्छा होगा, राइट. कंसिडरेशन होना चाहिए, लेकिन सर शेड्यूल वन याद रखिएगा, बिजनेस से रिलेटेड होना चाहिए लेकिन इंपोर्टेशन ऑफ सर्विस याद रखिएगा. अच्छा, कुछ कुछ सबसेक्शन टू आउटसाइड द स्कोप ऑफ जीएसटी है, और ये स्पेशल सेक्शन थ्री एनालाइज हो गया. तो इसका ये लोग शॉर्ट में समझाया है क्या इंक्लूड होगा क्या इंक्लूड नहीं होगा. सप्लाई एनी ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ सप्लाई, आपको जान के ये होगा, मतलब यू विल बी वेरी सरप्राइज दैट व्हेन इन एग्जाम्स व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू गेट दिस टाइप ऑफ डेफिनेशंस रादर देन राइटिंग इन पैराग्राफ फॉर्म आई यूज्ड टू क्रिएट दिस चार्ट्स कि सामने वाले को लग जाए कि हाँ ये बंदे को सब आता है. ठीक है, तो ये हो गया हमारा 1A, B, राइट. पूरा डेफिनेशन समझाया, देख लो. ठीक है, तो अभी हम लोग सबसे पहले एक एक पॉइंट के बारे में ये लोग एक एक सबसेक्शन को लेकर समझाया, बिकॉज यहीं पे टंग ट्विस्टर्स खेलेगा, वो लोग क्वेश्चंस देगा उसमें कहीं ना कहीं आपको कुछ कुछ फ्लॉ लगेगा एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू कैन आंसर द क्वेश्चन. अभी हम लोग बात करेंगे सप्लाई फॉर कंसिडरेशन इन द कोर्स, राइट. तो सप्लाई शुड बी ऑफ गुड्स सर्विसेज और बोथ, राइट. तभी हम लोग सप्लाई के बारे में बात करेंगे, दैट वहां पे बोला है ना ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ सप्लाई, राइट. वी विल टॉक अबाउट नाउ सप्लाई, सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज, जो पहला पॉइंट था हमारा कि सप्लाई होना चाहिए गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज का, राइट. इसके बारे में बात करेंगे. तो उसमें हम लोग ऑलरेडी जानते हैं कि मनी और सिक्योरिटीज नहीं आता है, राइट. अगर और कोई चीज का सप्लाई करेंगे तो वो जीएसटी के अंडर में आएगा ही नहीं, राइट. आइए, तो अपने फर्स्ट सेक्शन अभी हम लोग बात करेंगे सेक्शन 7 सबसेक्शन 1 क्लॉज ए. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू एनालाइज, एक एक करके एनालाइज करेंगे. सो सबसे पहले हम लोग एनालाइज कर रहे हैं नाउ वी आर एनालाइजिंग सबसे पहले section 1, sorry, section 7, subsection 1, clause A, right? हम लोग इस पार्ट को पहले एनालाइज करेंगे. पहले क्या बोलता है, इसमें बोला है ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स सर्विसेज और बोथ कंसिडरेशन होना चाहिए रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस होना चाहिए, राइट? ये तीन चीज याद रखना है, कंसिडरेशन ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ सप्लाई. मैं अगर गुड्स और सर्विसेज नहीं है तो जीएसटी के अंडर में आएगा ही नहीं. ठीक है, नाउ आई गिव यू वन एग्जांपल. अब हम लोग इसमें बहुत सारा एग्जांपल बात करेंगे. लिखो, फटाफट लिखो, क्विकली राइट. अ शॉपकीपर सोल्ड पेन फॉर रुपीज 100. टू द बायर सॉल्यूशन क्या है? दिस इज सेल ट्रांजैक्शन, यस और नो? और ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ सप्लाई मतलब ये सप्लाई है. सिंपल केस है ना? आप लोगों को लग रहा होगा मैं क्या करा रहा हूं, बट वेट करो, धीरे धीरे कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी बढ़ेगा. राइट? सो बेसिकली इन केस ऑफ सेल व्हाट डू यू लुक फॉर? इन केस ऑफ सेल व्हाट डू यू एग्जैक्टली लुक फॉर? ट्रांसफर ऑफ ओनरशिप टू बायर. And the seller does not have any right on that. Right? And but obvious, the position will also follow. Right? Example. Goods. Transferred from factory to depot for sale purpose, right? So इसको हम लोग transfer बोलते हैं. तो ये भी supply है, right? So this is simply transfer of goods from one place to another. अभी हम लोग सब चीज के बारे में बात ही नहीं कर रहे, right? We are simply understanding the first point, all forms of supply of goods, services, or both. Now barter system I don't have to explain, you give something and you get something in return, right? उसके बारे में बात करके कोई मतलब नहीं है. Right now, whether you license something, right, you are giving something for use, rent, lease, or dispose of, everything will constitute supply. You license, lease, rent, disposal, all will constitute supply with or without transfer of rights. If I am giving it for use, it will be regarded as supply, right? So you can write here with or without transfer of rights. Yes, जैसे होता है ना, हम लोग भाड़ा में लेते हैं, जैसे फाइनेंस लीज में क्या होता है, यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड फाइनेंस लीज. फाइनेंस लीज में क्या होता है, आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ द लीज टर्म यू गेट द ओनरशिप एज वेल. बट आउट हियर इट डजंट मैटर वेदर यू गेट द ओनरशिप और यू डोंट गेट द ओनरशिप, राइट? Right, so they will discuss this. We will discuss this later on when we talk about Schedule 2 in detail. Right, as one of my student asked me, ki sir, transfer of goods from factory to depot for sale purpose. Mera hi factory se hum apna hi shop mein bheje hai maal bechne ke liye. तो यहां तो इस पर्टिकुलर ट्रांसफर में कोई कंसिडरेशन नहीं है. तो अब हम लोग सेकेंड पॉइंट के बारे में बात करेंगे, दैट इज व्हेनेवर देयर इज एनी सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज और बोथ. सप्लाई मींस देयर इज सेल, एक्सचेंज, बार्टर, लाइसेंस, रेंट, लीज, डिस्पोजल, वट एवर, देयर हैज टू बी कंसिडरेशन. इट मस्ट बी रिलेटेड टू द बिजनेस. कंसिडरेशन होना बहुत जरूरी है. कंसिडरेशन नहीं है तो उसमें हम लोग को खाली वो एक्सेप्शन देखना, दैट इज शेड्यूल वन वाला, राइट? सो दैट कंसिडरेशन हैज टू बी देयर. जरूरी नहीं कि हमेशा कैश में ही हो, इट कैन बी इन काइंड एज वेल. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, राइट? लाइक वी ऑल्सो सीन दैट बाटर सिस्टम. और ऐसा जरूरी नहीं कि जो रिसिपियंट ऑफ सर्विस है वहां से थर्ड पार्टी से भी फ्लो कर सकता है, राइट? बट इफ आई हैव रिसीव्ड एनी सब्सिडी फ्रॉम सेंट्रल और द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, वो कंसिडरेशन में नहीं आएगा. क्लियर? And if there is any deposit which has been made and that has to be applied for the supply, उस supply में हम लोग adjust करेंगे तभी वो consider किया जाएगा. तो ये हम लोग बात कर चुके हैं. तो कोई भी supply है, कैसा भी supply है, but उसमें consideration होना चाहिए, otherwise वो definition fulfill नहीं कर रहा है. 1A का क्या है? all forms of supply made for a consideration. Yaad rakhiyega. It has to be made for a consideration and it should be related to the business. तो कंसिडरेशन थर्ड पार्टी दे चाहे रिसिपियंट दे उसे फर्क नहीं पड़ता है राइट सो ये सब चीज के बारे में आपको पूरा नॉलेज होना चाहिए तभी आप लोग इसको प्रॉपरली आगे कर पाएंगे ठीक है नाउ लेट मी गिव यू सम एग्जांपल्स डोनेशन received by charitable institution donation received by charitable trust from individual donors without something in return because when you get donation do you expect anything no that is quid pro quo you must have done it in law right to agar aisa hoga to yahan pe consideration nahi bol sakte apan kyunki yahan pe kuch sale nahi hua hai kuch transfer nahi hua hai kuch exchange nahi hua hai khali consideration hai So the consideration has to be for supply. यहाँ पे कुछ supply नहीं है, no supply is involved. ध्यान से सुनो, no supply is involved. ये चीज़ ध्यान देना है. ठीक है नाउ बहुत सारे संस्था में आप लोग देखेंगे अगर आप 10 लाख रुपए डोनेट करते तो वो लोग आपका नेम प्लेट लगा देता है तो इफ वो भी आपका एक सोशल इमेज क्रिएट करता है वो लोग बट आपको उससे कोई बिजनेस में तो कोई बेनिफिट नहीं है लेकिन मान लो अगर हम प्रोडक्ट का ब्रांडिंग करवाएं सो इन दैट केस वहां पर इनडायरेक्टली एक लिंक आ जाता है सप्लाई का राइट तो वो चीज हम लोगों को ध्यान से देखना पड़ेगा जब भी कोई डोनेशन इट हैज टू बी विद विदाउट समथिंग इन रिटर्न क्विड प्रो क्यू होना चाहिए तभी ये आपको नॉट टैक्सेबल इवेंट माना जाएगा नॉट अ टैक्सेबल इवेंट नॉट अ टैक्सेबल इवेंट राइट क्लियर अनदर एग्जांपल ठीक है नाउ जो आर्टिस्ट लोग होता है ना वो लोग अपना आर्ट को गैलरी में भेजता है आर्ट वर्क सेंट बाय आर्टिस्ट टू गैलरीज आर्ट गैलरी होता है ना फॉर एग्जीबिशन पर्पस तो यहां पर भी कोई कंसिडरेशन नहीं है तो ये सप्लाई नहीं माना जाएगा गैलरी वाला लोग आर्टिस्ट को कुछ नहीं देता हाँ अगर उसका वहां से बिक जाता है तो वो वाला टैक्सेबल इवेंट माना जाएगा, बट दिस मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स विल नॉट बी कंसिडर्ड एज, राइट? देयर इज नो कंसिडरेशन फ्रॉम गैलरी टू द आर्टिस्ट, नो कंसिडरेशन फ्रॉम गैलरी टू आर्टिस्ट, कोई कंसिडरेशन नहीं है, सो ये नो सप्लाई। तो इसी टाइप का आपसे एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन पूछेगा। ठीक है, नाउ अगर मान लो ये अभी मैं बात नहीं किया हूं शेड्यूल वन का, अगर ये जैसे ये आपने बोल दिया नो कंसिडरेशन मतलब नो सप्लाई प्रोवाइडेड इट इज नॉट कवर्ड इन शेड्यूल वन, अगर ये वाला पार्ट शेड्यूल वन में कवर्ड हुआ तो इवन इफ देयर इज नो कंसिडरेशन इट स्टिल बी लेवाइड जीएसटी। अभी मैं 7(1)(a) पढ़ा रहा हूं, याद करो इसका एक्सेप्शन है, इसका भी एक्सेप्शन है, so I'm not dealing with exceptions right now. ये सब definitions का खासियत क्या मालूम है, अभी बोल देगा supply नहीं है, जैसे no consideration no supply, फिर बाद में उसको schedule one में घुसा देगा activities treated as supply even without consideration। तो अभी हम लोग first part पढ़ रहे हैं, पूरा definition जब पढ़ लेंगे तब हम लोग overall picture मिल जाएगा कि ये वाला taxable है कि नहीं, क्योंकि schedule one पढ़ने के बाद अपने बता पाएंगे। ठीक है, नाउ बिजनेस से रिलेटेड होना चाहिए, तो कॉमन सेंस का बात है, अगर बिजनेस से रिलेटेड नहीं है तो उससे अपने को कोई लेना देना नहीं है। मैंने अपने घर का कोई गाड़ी बेचा है, सो दिस इज नॉट इन द कोर्स ऑफ बिजनेस, बिजनेस का कार बेचेंगे तो वो बिजनेस से रिलेशन में माना जाएगा। Right? So now you can see there are so many examples which they have given, which you can do at home. You can just ये सब read करना है आपको, right? तो ये सब मैंने आप लोगों को पढ़ा दिया है. Just read once. There are so many examples. Most of them I have used the same example, right? ये donations वाला example we have covered. पूरा लंबा discussion है, डेढ़ पेज का. They have discussed. Then artist वाला भी discussion हो चुका है, in the course of business वाला भी point discuss हुआ है, तो उसके लिए business का definition पूरा समझना है, इसीलिए अपने को बात किया ना हम लोग, volume है नहीं है उसे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, personal use वाला गाड़ी हम बेचे हैं तो वो supply नहीं माना जाएगा because वो business से related नहीं है, right? मैंने पेंटिंग्स बेच के कमाया है, उस कंसिडरेशन को आप कैसे खर्चा करते हैं, हाउ डू यू अप्लाई, इट डजंट मैटर, कंसिडरेशन होना चाहिए और बिजनेस से रिलेटेड होना चाहिए। मैं कमा के उसको पूरा उड़ा दिया, उससे थोड़ी आपका जीएसटी बच जाएगा, राइट? तो ये सब चीज पूरा पढ़ना है, ए बी सी, गुड सर्विसेस, ऑल फॉर्म्स, consideration and ये वाला चीज, right? नाउ कुछ कुछ ट्रांजैक्शंस का टैक्सेबिलिटी है जो हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास में बात करेंगे, अभी नहीं बात करेंगे. दिस वी विल डील इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन, राइट? सो टिल देन गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड डू रिवाइज दीज थिंग्स एट होम.
आप वीडियो देख रहे हैं.